Previously, we talked about the Lightning module and the Lightning trainer to organize our PyTorch code. However, those were mainly for the model. So there's yet another useful thing in Lightning, namely organizing our data loaders. So in this video, we will be discussing the organization of our data loaders using data modules. So a data module is a shareable, reusable class in Lightning that encapsulates the data processing and the data loading logic. So here's an outline of how a data module might look like for the MNIST dataset. So as you can see, there are several methods here. So let's talk through them step by step. Let's start with the prepare data method. So the prepare data method contains the logic for loading our dataset. So here in this case, we use the MNIST class from TorchVision to load the MNIST dataset. But why is this useful? Why do we have this organization with this prepare data method? Why don't we just put everything into the init method? The reason is that it avoids duplication of the data download if we use multiple GPUs, for example. So it's essentially making the code organization specifically for multi-GPU training more efficient. But we will come back to multi-GPU computing in a future unit, in Unit 9. Then there is also a setup method here in the data module, and the setup method contains code that can be executed multiple times. So for example, if we have multiple GPUs, each GPU needs to execute this code so that the data set becomes available in that GPU memory. So while the prepare data set method is only executed once, the setup method is executed on each GPU separately, if we have a multi-GPU training setup. If your model training happens only on a single GPU, or it happens on the CPU, you technically don't have to distinguish between the setup and the prepare data method. You can actually put all of the code in either one of the two methods. However, it's really best practice to separate the code in this particular way so that all the code that can be executed multiple times goes into the setup method, and the code that should only be executed once, for example the data download, goes into the prepare data method. Note that we haven't covered data augmentation yet, but we will also revisit that topic in the future, in Unit 7. Then, after our prepare data and after our setup method, we have these different methods for loading the data. So here, these are just methods to set up our data loaders as usual. For example, our training loader, our validation set loader, and the test set loader. And then there's also predict data loader for new data. And by the way, note that we only have to define these methods. We don't have to call them ourselves. When we pass a data module to the Lightning trainer, the trainer will actually be responsible for using these data loaders. So for example, when we call trainer.fit, it will use the training loader and the validation loader during the fitting procedure. The training data is of course used during the data fitting, and the validation loader is then used during the data validation step. And then if we want to evaluate our model, we can call trainer.test, which will then run the test data loader from the data module. And then when we call trainer.predict, then it will actually do the prediction on the new data in the predict data loader method. So once we have defined our data module and instantiated a new data module object, usage is actually pretty straightforward. So here we have the example of the MNIST data module. So for example, we can call the trainer.fit method on the model in the data module to train the neural network. And during that process, it will also use the validation set to evaluate our model. Then we can call trainer.test to get the prediction performance on the test set via the trainer.validate method. We can manually also again compute the validation set performance, and then by calling trainer.predict, we get the predictions on the new data. So, in this video, I gave you a brief outline of how data modules work and how we can use them to organize our code. In the next video, we are going to take these concepts and actually add them to our Lightning trainer script to see how they work in practice.